Hi everyone, today is the first Sunday after Easter. Let us be reminded on how Christ triumphed over sin and death, so that all who trust in Him will have a new life in this world and an everlasting life in the world to come. Let's prepare our hearts for worship. For our call to worship, found in Psalm 133, verses 1 to 3. How very good and pleasant it is when kindred live together in unity. It is like the dew of Hermon. For the Lord and ordained his blessing. Let us worship our God.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the blessings of life and health. Thank you for allowing us to have the opportunity to be in your presence again today. We come together with the unity of our faith and ask that everything we bind be bound in heaven. We ask that you manifest your glory today and shine your light on us. Forgive us our sins, Lord. We pray that you cleanse our souls for our iniquities so that we can be worthy of your presence. Help us to enjoy your blessings so that we may come to worship you. Bring the wonder of your strength and power as you visit us today. Keep us alive and a good wealth to continue to serve you. Let all of our desires and needs be met by you today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's offer our praise and worship to Him, where our hope rests because He is risen.
Yeah. Welcome po, Pasadena Yem Relief Church, sa ating online service. And today is our second Sunday of Easter. And tapos na po yung ating first Sunday. And so this a couple of Sundays, we will be studying from the book of Acts, where Jesus Christ spent the last 40 days of his time before ascending to heaven. And so our text for this afternoon is found in the book of Acts, chapter 4, verses 23 to 37. Before we start, let's bow our heads in a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for this wonderful afternoon. Guide us, open our hearts and our minds as we study your word. And as we listen, may you speak continually into our hearts, and may we be able to apply your word into our lives. This we ask in the most precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So today, our second Sunday of Easter, and we will be focusing on the book of Acts. And our theme is about the first church. So maraming mga first churches ngayon where nakalagay yung first dun sa kanilang name, no? But going back to history, we are going to focus on the very first church where it all began after Jesus Christ ascended. And we're going to read from the book of Acts 4, verses 23 to 37. And I will read, "When they were released, they went to their friends and reported what the chief priest and the elders had said to them. And when they heard it, they lifted their voices together to God and said, 'Sovereign Lord, who made the heaven and the earth and the sea and everything in them, who through the mouth of our father David, your servant, said by the Holy Spirit, why did the Gentiles rage and the peoples plot in vain? The kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and against his anointed. For truly in this city there were gathered together against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed, both Herod and Pontius Pilate, along with the Gentiles and the peoples of Israel, to do whatever your hand and your plan had predestined to take place. And now, Lord, look upon their threats and grant to your servants to continue to speak your word with all boldness while you stretch out your hand to heal, and signs and wonders are performed through the name of your holy servant Jesus.' And when they had prayed, the place in which they were gathered together were shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and continued to speak the word of God with boldness. Now the full number of those who believed were one of heart and soul, and no one said that any of the things that belonged to him was his own, but they had everything in common. And with great power, the apostles were giving their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as were owners of lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold and laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. Thus Joseph, who was also called by the apostles Barnabas, which means sons of encouragement, a Levite, a native of Cyprus, sold the field that belonged to him and brought the money and laid it at the apostles' feet." So those were the events on the first church. And so we're going to talk about the people's consecration from verses 23 to 31, where it says that when they were released, they went to their friends and reported what the chief priest and the elders had said to them. And so what happened before this event was that the disciples were warned not to preach about Jesus Christ, and they were somewhat punished by being lashed. And when they were released, they were happy after the punishment. You know why? Because Jesus was already telling them about the sufferings that they will encounter, and this is part of what will happen to them. No, they were expecting this, and so they were glad and they were joyous that they are being that they are suffering in the name of Jesus Christ. And as soon as they were freed, they went to join their own people, praising of the event. This is on the book of also Acts on the verses 24 to 25. And it says, when they heard it, they lifted their voices together to God and said, Sovereign Lord, who made the heaven and the earth and the sea and everything in them, who through the mouth of our father David, your servant, said by the Holy Spirit, why did the Gentiles rage and the peoples plot in vain? So despite being persecuted, they praised the Lord. And if you will notice, that particular verse in the end, why did the Gentiles rage and the peoples plot in vain, is a footnote from the book of Psalm, chapter 2, verse 1. If you will look in the book of Psalm, chapter 2, verse 1, it says, why do the nations rage and the peoples plot in vain? So there's a prophecy involved. And this is in continuation of the verses 26 to 28, where he says, the king of the earth set themselves and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and against his anointed. For truly in the city, there were gathered together against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed, both Herod and Pontius Pilate, along with the Gentiles and the peoples of Israel, to do whatever your hand and your plan had predestined to take place. So this, there is another partial quote from the book of Psalm, chapter 2, verse 1 to 3, showing Christ as Lord, the highest of all, and ruler of the world. So there was a plea in verses 29 to 30. It says, and now, Lord, look upon their hearts and grant to your servants to continue to speak your word with all boldness while you stretch out your hand to heal, and signs and wonders are performed through the name of your holy servant Jesus. So this was after the Holy Spirit, after they were baptized by the Holy Spirit after the Pentecost. So they were healing people in the name of Jesus Christ. So there were great miracles that had happened. The question of some theologians, if that may still happen today. Of course, theologians differ from their perspective, but God can still do miracles today. So the disciples did not pray for freedom, but for boldness as they spoke God's word. They asked that God reach out his hand and heal. So they continue to pray. And in verse 31, it says, and when they had prayed, the place in which they were gathered together was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and continued to speak the word of God with boldness. So they prayed for boldness, for courage to preach the word of God, and God grant their prayer. So there are three steps that we can take note of in terms of prayer. First, Prayer is the secret to success. If you wanted to succeed in life, we need to pray more. And some people find it hard to pray in the early wee hours in the morning, but there are ways we can do prayer. And one is to find a place where you can be able to commune and communicate with God. And so the place was shaken as the result of prayer. That's the second point. The third point is the power of prayer. They spoke God's word with boldness. And so when we talk about courage, boldness, the motive of the first disciples or the apostles then was granted because of the right motive in terms of their prayer. And sometimes when we pray nowadays, sometimes we wish for material things that can be seen and touched, but that's not the kind of motive the disciples, the first church, had when they were asking or praying to the Lord. They asked for boldness. For the second point, we will notice that there's the people's cooperation. Let's read from verses 32 to 33. Now the full number of those who believed were one of heart and soul, and no one said that any of the things that belonged to him was his own, but they had everything in common. And with great power, the apostles were giving their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. So there was an unusual cooperation from the unusual people. These are regular people that had heard Christ, and so they had everything in common, and they are in one heart and in one soul. And that is written in verse 32. Now the full number of those who believe were of one heart and soul, and no one said that any of the things that belonged to him was his own, but they had everything in common. So this is the principle of stewardship. Everything that we have in our life is not our own. If that is our principle, it will be easy for us to give to anyone who is in need, or to give our tithes, or to our church, no? When we do fundraising. Why? Because we have this innate idea. No, this is just not an idea, but God, everything that we have is a blessing from the Lord. We do not own these things. It was just given to us so that we can use it for His glory. So if that is our perspective, we will not be attached to anything that we have in this life. And so this is the kind of heart they had during the time of the first church. They had the same feelings towards each other. They have one heart. They have one soul. All had the same spiritual desires. And they have one desire, which they shared with others. And so we move to the people's compassion. In verses 34 to 37, it says there was not a needy person among them, For as many as were owners of lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold and laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. Thus Joseph was also called by the apostles Barnabas, which means sons of encouragement, a Levite, a native of Cyprus, sold the field that belonged to him and brought the money and laid it at the apostles' feet. So Barnabas was well known because of his generosity. And he was named an alias, which is son of encouragement. By his name, it was connected to his name, as he was an encourager. He encouraged people who needs who are down, depressed. And I think that's one trait that we can adapt. When nowadays people are depressed because of COVID, they could not get out, especially here in the Philippines, there are so many infection. And there were times that, especially the children, they were hit by the depression because they could not get out of their places. And so we pray that each and every one of us will be endowed with the gift of encouragement. And because of that, there is a kind of sameness of trait, which the sameness was not, there was not a needy person among them in verse 34. For as many as were owners of lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold. So every Christian sold their property and they gave it to those who are in need. The people sold their houses and shared their money with other poor Christians. And this was before they had welfare or social security. So they share. That's a wonderful trait of the first church Christians, first century Christians then. They laid it at the apostles' feet, in verse 35, and it was distributed to each as any had need. The people sold their homes and gave money to the disciples, and the disciples are in charge of giving it to those who are in need. And they surrender what they have. Thus, Joseph, who was also called by the apostles Barnabas, sold his land and gave money to the disciples. The question, should Christians sell their homes and give the money to the church? The Bible says that first we should take care of our families. Now, during the first century church, when they heard about Christ, they really sold everything they had and they went to the desert. That's what happened with the Cappadocian fathers. They lived like a hermit in the desert land. Now, that's a different time and place and context. Now, there's verses where we should take care of our families. If we wanted to be a good Christian, we should not fail to provide to our parents, to our friends, or to our relatives who are in need. We should give our tithes to the Lord. You know, God may ask us if we are willing to surrender everything to Him. We should obey Him no matter what He may tell us to do. And God wants to be first in our lives. And that's what the first century Christians did during that time. Today, our second Sunday of Easter, we pray that we continue to do what the first church had done, giving and sharing what they had, and not to be attached with material wealth, and you know, giving thanks to the Lord for everything that He has given us by giving back to those who are in need in our community, in our church. And I'm sure God will be pleased of the deeds that we are doing because we are following what the first church had done when they heard about Christ. They make sure that their lives are being used by God, and God is first in their lives. Maraming salamat po, Pasadena, and may God bless us all.
for our sending forth found in John 20:19-29. Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." But Thomas was not with them when Jesus came. Jesus said, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe."
Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for this second Sunday of Easter. Thank you for the first church giving us a good example of how we can follow you and do what you've intended us to do as Christians, to follow your example. We thank you for your blessings to each and everyone. May be able to share what we have, just like what the first church did. And as we conclude our worship service, may your Holy Spirit bless each and every one of us today. Now to him who is able to keep you from falling, to present you without fault and with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, Jesus Christ, be glory, majesty, dominion, and authority before all time, now and forevermore. Amen and amen.
Who is able to keep you from falling, or to make you stand in his presence, nameless and with great joy? To the only God, Jesus Christ our Lord, give glory and the majesty, dominion and authority, for now and forever. Dominion and authority.